It's not really surprising, looking at these images released by the US Navy's Typhoon Warning Center, that meteorologists and weather forecasters were able to predict so accurately just how big the storm would be. And imagine how terrifying a warning for the thousands of people in its path.
Only now is the true horror becoming clear to the outside world. But these people have lived the nightmare for 3 days now. Dealing with the aftermath must be as tough as surviving the storm itself. More pictures of Friday's typhoon are now emerging. In places, the winds reached almost 200 miles an hour. That makes it one of the most powerful storms ever recorded on land. It flattened flimsy homes as well as sturdier buildings. Many people would have been killed by collapsing walls or flying debris. Even evacuation centers are reported to have been severely damaged. But the wind also created a storm surge, with powerful waves sweeping across the islands. A huge number of victims drowned. When the water receded, it left behind evidence of its force. The province of Leyte and its capital Tacloban appears to have been the worst hit.
We have an estimated event on the castle is more or less 10,000 on this report for the whole province of Leyte.
What to do with the dead is one problem, but how to help the living is more urgent. No food, no power, no shelter. Several million people desperately in need. Aid agencies are comparing the levels of destruction to the Boxing Day tsunami a decade ago. But at least the typhoon arrived with plenty of advance warning. Hundreds of thousands of people had taken refuge. Tourists will have an escape route out of the chaos eventually, but it's not easy. With communications down, people queued to be allowed a maximum of 3 minutes on the internet so they could get in touch with friends and relatives. With so much infrastructure destroyed on this island nation, it's impossible to know how badly more remote areas have been hit. It could be many days before the full scale of this tragedy is revealed.
The initial assessment showed that Haiyan left a wake of massive destruction that is unprecedented, unthinkable, and horrific, and the devastation is staggering. I struggle to find words even for the images that we see on the news coverage, and I struggle to find words to describe how I feel about the losses. We can fix this. We can stop this madness.
Thank you, Philippines, for your great. great speech